Hello, today I want to talk about how a submarine can sink and rise. Most submarines have two types of tanks, the main ballast tank and the trim tanks. The main ballast tank is used to move the ship up and down. The trim tanks are used to balance the ship. Let's take a look at the main ballast tank first. If the tank is filled with air, the submarine is lighter than the surrounding water, and it will float on the surface. If the tank is filled with water, the submarine is heavier than the surrounding water, and it will sink. The main ballast tank has holes on the bottom and a valve on the top. As long as the valve is closed, the air bubble is trapped in the tank. If you open the valve, the water pressure is forcing the air out of the tank. As there is more and more water getting into the tank, the ship is getting heavier and it's starting to sink. If you want the submarine to rise again, you need to replace the water with air again. To achieve that, compressed air is pumped into the tank. The air pressure is pushing the water out of the tank, and the ship is getting lighter again. As the compressed air is a limited resource, you want to waste as little as possible of it. Therefore, the last bits of water are normally pressed out by normal air or by using the fumes of the diesel engine. The second type of tanks are the trim tanks. Normally, the trim tanks are positioned at the front and at the back of the submarine. As I mentioned earlier, the trim tanks are used to balance the submarine. Let's assume the front part of the submarine is heavier than its back. In that case, water from the front tank can be pumped to the tank in the back until the ship is in balance again. When the submarine is submerged, it can also use its diving planes to move up and down.